The Willamette River today is a far cry from what it was 50 years ago. The water is much cleaner. Clean enough, according to health experts, to safely swim in. Clean enough for migrating fish to swim through. But it still has a ways to go. While native fish have returned to some stretches, others are still struggling.
In Newburgh, I think it was, we only saw two species of fish, a total of two species in the entire site. And all of those fish had signs of external injury or disease.
Oregon State University researcher Bob Hughes was part of an international team of scientists studying rivers around the world, including right here in Oregon. Their focus? The fish and insects that call those rivers and streams home. What they discovered was not good.
50% to 40% of the streams are in poor condition.
In the places studied, many species were either declining, threatened, or endangered.
If it's in really bad shape, we actually see fishes that have external causes of disease or indications of disease like tumors or lesions. And in some of the areas that we have samples from, say South America or Asia, there are no fish and there are hardly any bugs in the rivers.
It's an eye-opening study and one the Oregon DEQ applauds. The agency has conducted similar studies and found similar results, although it found Oregon rivers are doing better with only about a quarter in poor condition. So how can we help? Hugh says the best thing we can do is restore the natural vegetation and habitat around rivers and streams. Give them a natural filter and then keep watch.
It's important to monitor. It's the same as it's important to test for COVID. Otherwise, we don't know what's going on.
Because if we don't help our planet's rivers recover now, Hughes says, they'll eventually become dangerous for human health. We've seen how once nasty rivers can become much healthier. Just take a look at the Willamette. In Portland, Keely Chalmers, KGW News.